Welcome back. It's great to see you again. Today we are covering while loops. Now, while loops are extremely practical because they let us cycle through code again and again without writing all that code by hand. And I would say while loops are a lazy programmer's best friend. Let's have a closer look at what we can do with while loops. So while loops will essentially repeat the same task over and over again while the condition specified in the while loop remains true. I will give you an example from mathematics which illustrates why while loops are so useful. We will let the user enter a number and then we will calculate the factorial of this number. If you don't know what the factorial is, here's a quick reminder. A factorial is essentially the product of an integer and all the integers below it down to 1. So, for example, if I have 3, I would calculate 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1, giving me 6. We will save the results of our calculation in a variable called result, and we will initially give it the value of the number that the user entered. Here comes our while loop. We will write the word while, which is our keyword, and then in parentheses, we will write a condition that needs to be true for the while loop to run. In this case, as long as the user number is greater than 1, because we want to go down to 1. For instance, in our example, when we had 3, we went 3, 2, 1. Now, every time we go through this loop, we need to reduce the user number by 1, which we do in this line. And we need to calculate the new result, so our new result is going to be the old result multiplied by the user number. This might look a little complicated, so let's go through this with an example. Let's take 3 as an example. I want to find the factorial of 3, so the number I enter is 3, meaning my user number is 3. My result is also 3 now. I will start the loop now, and the first time I go through the loop, I will set the user number to 2, because the user number is user number, which is 3 minus 1, which gives us a 2, and I will set the result to 3 multiplied by 2, meaning 6. I will run through the loop again, because the user number is still greater than 1, it's 2 at the moment. And my new user number is going to be 2 minus 1, so it's going to be 1. And my result is going to be 6 multiplied by 1, which is still 6. And that's when the loop ends, because 1 is not greater than 1 anymore. I'll do a second example. Let's assume our number is 4. So on the first iteration, the user number is going to be 3, and the result is going to be 4 multiplied by 3, meaning 12. On the second iteration, my user number is going to be 2, because we're subtracting 1. And my result is going to be 24. And on the third iteration, the user number is going to be 1, and my result is going to be 24, which is 24 multiplied by 1. So you can see this loop is fairly easy when you go through it with concrete examples. Now, what's left to do is print the results, and we're going to write the factorial of your chosen number is, and then here we print the result. And remember that the result is an integer and we need to convert it to a string to print it like this. Here we go. Let's now test this. Please enter a number. I enter 3, and yes, the factorial of your chosen number is 6. I enter 4, and it is 24 indeed. Very nice. Of course, our program becomes really useful if we use high numbers like 25, you can see my result and it is quite high. It would take forever to calculate this in your head.
we could choose an even higher number, like 30, and you can see how high the result is now. So just to make sure that you've mastered the while loop, let's go over it again. Use the keyword while, and then in parentheses you specify under which condition the while loop should be executed. In this case, I'm using a control variable, and I say as long as the control variable is greater than 3. And then I need to specify what should happen in the while loop. Here I'm using a simple print command. And of course I need to specify what the control variable is. I'll do that here in the first line. In my case I will say 10. And I need to make sure the control variable changes inside the loop, otherwise the loop would just run forever. And we get something that programmers call an infinite loop, and that is not a good thing to have, because your program would continue running forever and might even crash your computer. So let's give this a quick try. You can see here, hello is printed exactly 7 times, as could be expected. Of course, I can change the control variable, I can change the condition inside the while statement, and with that, I have complete control over how many times this loop is executed. So in this example, it is executed exactly 3 times, as you can see. All right, let's do a quick summary of what we learned. We learned how the while loop works. You use while as a keyword, and then in parentheses, you specify how long the while loop should be executed. Make sure that inside the while loop, you change the control variable so that at some point the while loop ends. Anything that happens at each iteration of the loop should be inside the while loop, meaning that you need to indent it. And that means you just use the tab key to move the text a little to the right.
That's it. I think you can agree that while loops are fairly easy and very useful. You just have to remember the control variable inside the while loop and that you need to change it to avoid getting an infinite loop. But did you know that you can actually put a loop inside another loop? Yeah, it's getting a little more complex now. But don't worry, we'll cover this as well in our next lesson. See you then.